Okay, so we have a lovely young lady here today from Texas. She came all the way for her rhinoplasty and I'm very excited for her. She's very smart, I can tell you that, and she's very pretty. It's just the nose that she wants to improve. So I completely get it, and we are going to do this actually under local anesthesia. She wanted it under local. She did not want to be put to sleep and have the, you know, breathing tube down. So that's what we're trying to achieve today. And if you take a look from the front, you know, it's not that bad. It's just the tip is a little bulbous, and it's not really that bulbous, just a little bulbous. So, but if you look at my tip is so beautiful. See that? My tip is so beautiful. She got jealous. So she saw my video of rhinoplasty and she wants to look. See what I'm talking about? It's not hard. It's not easy to find a good looking plastic surgeon, right? Don't laugh. Okay, let's get back here.
All right.
So that's what we have to do. So that's the one aspect. But the bigger issue is if you can see from the side. So I'm going to show you from the side. So I'm going to have her turn around. So, so if you look in here, so the hump almost pushes the tip downward. You can see how bad it is. See that? Big hump. And then when she smiles or laughs, see what happens? There she goes. Exactly. So it looks like a beak. You know, and this is unfortunately very common in my culture, my ethnic background of India, Pakistan, where we have this, you know, beaky thing. That's why I had my surgery. So we want to get rid of that. And taking the hump off is going to really help elevate a tiny bit and make it a little straight to a tiny slide maybe. So that's the goal. And it's going to be closed approach. We'll take a little cephalic trim on both sides. We'll do the hump reduction with cartilage excision and osteotomies, and then do the osteotomies on the sides to make it narrow again and appropriate for the face. So that's the plan. Let's get started. Yay! So we are ready to start, and we have done the anesthetizing, and we started with the blocks, sphenopalatine blocks inside, nasopalatine block also from inside and from outside, infraorbital nerve blocks, and then trochlear blocks, upper lateral nasal nerve blocks, and then local infiltration. And we've marked the cephalic trim that we want to do. It's not excessive. And then we're going to get started. So we'll show you the whole thing. Voila. Very excited. So everything is going just picture perfect. And trust me, this is not the norm. I don't want the young surgeons to think like, oh, it's so easy. A lot of training goes into it. So always please be prepared, prepare, prepare, prepare. I'm gonna have Stephanie turn around and show, there's a checklist right there. So you know what, there's a checklist right there. And I follow it to the T. That's very important. The more checklists you have, the more times you prepare in your mind, the easier it is. So if now you come back, I wanna show you exactly what we set out to do. So we set out to do local rhinoplasty, so there's no pain, and also to get the cartilages from the cephalic trim and the hump. So we have been able to accomplish that, as you can see. Also, we want to make sure the patient is comfortable. How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
How bad? What's, go ahead.
I feel comfortable. I don't feel any pain. Just a little pressure, of course,
okay,
with the osteotomies. But other than that, it's, I feel at ease, so
fantastic.
I feel great. Thank
wonderful,
you.
Wonderful. That's great. Thank you. Okay, go back to sleep if you can.
Sure.
Oh boy, we are done. Look at the smile. Yes, look at that. She's happy. She's happy. Mission accomplished. And she has been looking nonstop on her hump in her hand. So right there it is. Yes, she's holding the hump. She never wants to see it again. So there we go. That's the hump and the cartilage from the nose as well.
I'm saying goodbye.
Yes, she's saying goodbye to it. There you go. Bye-bye. There we go. So let's take a good look. Looks great. Let's do a little horizontal view in a second. There we go. Fantastic. Good. Great. Well, we'll see her back in 4 or 5 days, take the splint off, and then she'll be able to go back home.
Yeah.
Okay, here we are. So we are 5 days post-op, and as you can see, the osteotomies did cause a little bruising, but the nose is nice and narrow now, and this is very early result, and it's gonna keep getting better as we go along, and hopefully we'll keep you posted. Depends on our lovely patient, if she sends the pictures and now, but she is very responsible. So I'm very happy because we got a nice like change, and you can see that the hump is completely gone. So that is a big, big change. I mean, this is just amazing. And the tip looks very appropriate. So it's adequately narrowed, it's straight, it's not fake looking, and nobody will be able to tell she had anything done. But she doesn't have to worry about the big hump or the wide nose. So very excited.